behalf of the Department of Finance and Business Economics, University of Delhi, extend our heartfelt greetings to everyone gathered here for the 36th annual convention organized by the Association of Finance and Control.
Our coming together not only depicts our participation, but also our role as a compass guiding the ship in the ever-vast, ever-evolving sea of finance. This convention stands as a beacon illuminating the way forward in the dynamic financial world. With a specific focus on the green financial services sector, which also aligns with our theme for today, Green Footprints in Financial Services. This convention is a testament to the power of collaboration and shared goals. We are immensely elated to extend a warm welcome to Professor Sanjay Sehgal, Dr. Varun Dhawan, Dr. Pankaj Chaudhary, Dr. Ritesh Kumar Mishra, and Dr. Saurabh Singh for honoring us with their presence today.
Moving forward, we would like to request Mr. Ankit Kumar, the President of AFCON, to address the gathering and officially begin this convention.
Good morning. I am Ankit Kumar, President, Association of Finance and Control, AFCON, and it is my immense pleasure to welcome you all to this 36th annual convention hosted by AFCON. AFCON stands as vanguard of support and growth for the students pursuing MBA Finance course at DFB, University of Delhi. The MBA Finance program, earlier known as Master of Finance and Control, launched by erstwhile Department of Financial Studies way back in 1987. Was a foray into the uncharted territory in the Indian education scenario. At the heart of our vision lies a profound commitment to nurturing a sense of ethics, social awareness, and public responsibility. Our core mission is to excel the study and practice of accounting and finance while simultaneously fostering opportunities for personal development, community service, and collaboration among our members and established professionals. In the line of this mission, we strive to cultivate an environment which is holistic to learning, that is not just professional but also rooted in ethical values. We are dedicated to providing an array of resources to our members, both within and beyond our organization. In addition to our overreaching mission, AFCON operates through a network of dedicated committees, each with its unique role and purpose. The committees play a crucial role in development of organization and shaping it, ensuring its success. One such committee is Corporate Relations and Placement Committee that works tirelessly to bridge the gap between members and the industry leaders, facilitating internships and job placements to kickstart their careers. Our Corporate Communication and Public Relations team takes the charge of keeping the stakeholders informed about our activities, achievements, and takes the charge of our PR activities. The Alumni Committee maintains a strong connection with our graduates, creating a thriving alumni network that offers guidance and support to the current members. Another committee is Convention and Logistics Committee that is responsible for meticulously planning and executing events like this annual convention, which used to held every year, ensuring that every detail is taken care to provide seamless experience. Lastly, the Entrepreneurship and International Relation that encourages innovation and global engagement, fostering an entrepreneurial spirit among our members, while nurturing the international connections and collaboration. These committees, driven by the dedicated members like yourself, are the backbone of success of AFCON, and we invite you to explore the opportunities they offer and contribute to the collective growth. So, as we come together to celebrate the journey and embark this new chapter of learning growth, let us remember, AFCON is not just an association, it's a vibrant community which fosters the growth of our all to the professional development and the betterment of society as a whole. Thank you for being part of this convention, and together, let's make it an unforgettable experience. Thank you.
Ms. Chandrika Bharti, Secretary of the Convention Committee, to share a few words with us.
Good morning, everyone. I, Chandrika Bharti, stand before you with the great pride as Convention Secretary of DFS, welcoming you all to our DFS Convention, teachers event of our institution with the legacy of over three decades that offer a dynamic platform for intellectual disclosure on a myriad of issues relating to the financial sector in a particular. So, this event is not just a gathering, but a platform to foster knowledge. As Thomas Fuller once said, zeal without knowledge is of discussions on emerging trends in consulting, credit rating, banking, green building finance, mutual funds, and ESG investing. Over the years, we have been honored to host multiple speakers from various fields who have shared their invaluable insights with us. I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to all our respected guests, speakers, and mentors for taking out the time to be here today and share their wisdom with us. And a very special thanks to Alpha Capital for sponsoring this year's convention. At the end, thanks to all for joining us. Let's engage and learn together for a brighter future. Let the convention begin.
Part of our DFS family. Dr. Sanjay Sehgal is a senior professor and former head of Department of Finance and Business Economics, University of Delhi. He is also former dean of Faculty of Applied Social Sciences and Humanities. He is a PhD holder from Delhi School of Economics and has done his postdoctorate from Department of Finance, London School of Economics. He has a teaching experience of about 35 years in the field of investment valuation, portfolio management, Low French Social Services Award in 2007, and SRCC Illustrious Alumni Award in 2008. He has been a member in several university and government committees. He has acted as jobs for leading companies and professional associations. We kindly request Professor Sehgal to come up on the stage and address the
So when the students came this year and we started discussion about the theme, every year we devote a lot of time to work out the theme for the program. And
politically sensitive issue, we normally keep it aside and focus more on the industry. But that's what has happened. Contribution to pollution is very high. And then we move to the threshold, those who are at the threshold level, and then maybe expand. Companies obviously have to manage these issues because they can't punish the world or society at large or other stakeholders in their pursuit of profits. In the world of corporate finance, which you are more than environment around you, you can't simply inflict pain to other stakeholders just because you have to keep only the equity holders, have stakeholders in the system. It could be your employees, it could be other people linked in the vertical chain. I can just paint a landscape over there. But these are not jargons anymore. If you ask, you have your seniors here or corporate officials here. These are serious issues. They're dealing with sustainable reporting. The linked issue is sustainable accounting, which is carbon accounting. How do I account for my emissions? Scope 1, scope 2, scope 3. Even if I am able to measure my system and I find, say, two simple pillar, first which is environment, that I am actually contributing to the CO2 equivalent gases exercise. That's the part which companies have to become serious about. The consulting firms have suddenly realized in the last decade that what they need to advise about management or design the ESG matrix has become a vital issue. So obviously this is business there. So companies have to manage it. Consulting have to help them in giving it for a good cause. And my issue as a banker is I'm here to do business. I'm not here to do charity. So if Sanjeev has to do business, he'll make money, and I'm not supposed to do charity at my place of business. I can go and donate in a temple or to our convention if you want next time. So the critical issue is that how are we balancing these things? The critical issue is that subsidization will not come simply because of empathy, which is the cost of debt and cost of equity. Subsidization will come either there is an excess demand for these funds. Okay, so as a supplier, I'm okay because a lot of people want actually the investment to be done in green goods and services because the consumers demand goods and services. And the companies know in order to survive, their goods and services are continuously being watched to be green. When the consumer movement and the consumer consciousness starts, the trickle down effect will go to finance because automatically the supplier funds will be there and cost will come down. So cost will not come down because of equity initially. Maybe there may be some initial support And therefore there is a debate, is the cost of equity and cost of debt internationally for green bonds has gone down compared to a regular bond. There is no conclusive evidence to show what happens. But what's the financial market architecture to handle all this, including the after you have done with climate science? Issue is, where do I get the money for? One issue is that till the time technologies evolve and I adopt technologies and they become cost effective, is there a way I can mitigate my risk, or I can purchase or sell my risk, which is you need emission trading systems. Europe recognized this need from Kyoto Protocol way back in 2005. Europe rolled out the first EU ETS in 2005. It's the largest EU ETS in the world. Trading systems across the world which are working. Where does India stand? We launched our ETS, or announced rather our ETS, only last year. The first white paper exposure draft is right down there. And the biggest debate is how should many other industries. For the China defines greenhouse gases only as CO2. Europe defines greenhouse as in terms of pollution to what we define in terms of one CO2 unit. And India is almost the third largest polluter. Have pledged in UN and given targets to be carbon neutral by 2070. So obviously things are complex. The ecosystem has to evolve now in India. In the next 5 to 7 years, this also becomes not only with sections about 40 to 50 minutes each. I think even if this topic is able to make you aware of some of these critical issues, and at least some of us as consumers think about special guests over here, and I think they will throw more light on the ideas I've thrown over there. Thank you.
Professor Sehgal, for enlightening us and setting the perfect tone for today's convention. Now, with immense pleasure, we welcome Mr. Sanjeev Saraf, a distinguished investment banker with an impressive track record spanning over 27 years. Mr. Saraf's expertise has left an indelible mark on the capital markets, encompassing various domains such as corporate finance, venture capital, private wealth, retail distribution, and fintech. His wealth of industry experience is an immensely invaluable resource for us, and we consider it a profound honor to have him grace our annual event as the chief guest. As the saying goes, experience is the best teacher, and we are fortunate to have someone of Mr. Saraf's caliber to share his experiences and insights with us today. Mr. Saraf, can you share a few words with us?
Respected Professor Manish, Professor Sehgal, Professor Florent, Professor Dawar, all professors at the university, my dear colleagues and alumni members, and dear students of the 35th or the 26th batch of MFC, DFS, DFB, whatever you call it. When I see the evolution, and the evolution is what makes an edge. You, the batches of 24th or the 36th batch, are lucky on what happened all these years behind. It's like the Indian independence, right? 75 years, but what went into the independence is something that you should know. And Professor Munis and Professor Sehgal are two pillars. And I have no hesitation in saying that today what is existing, whatever it is also because of their efforts. I really need it's a truth. We would not have existed. There came a time when I thought my MFC degree is more valuable. And suddenly somebody told me that you are now an MBA finance, you're not an MFC. I think I have yet to get a new degree, Professor, of MBA finance. Maybe there is a provision to replace that MFC degree with MBA finance. I'd be happy to get it. But coming here as a chief guest is something which I don't know decorative, and I am proud and privileged member of this class to be here to share my thoughts. And I can only say that when I see trends that happened in this country, I'm not talking about the world. Anybody answering that question as a student of finance? In January it happened for one tranche. Disinformation also. And I would actually urge you not to depend on ChatGPTs. I'm actually saying that, not to depend. if you, people who have not raised their hands, you don't read the financial newspaper, you do not have the right to become a financial professional in time. We're working overnight to give you information in a condensed manner with the climate change. It'll all cover your face. What Professor Sehgal said was kind of a nectar, and that is what I say. Professors are the ways to receive the nectar of so many flowers of information. And please pay attention to what's happening today in today's world. So when you go through the sessions today, as you write, a curtain raiser as to what you should look at. And each one of you decide for yourself, not come to your careers. My own batches, people did not get jobs, but they are one of the most successful entrepreneurs or industrialists or corporate in the world. So what does it mean to you? What is the actual reality of life? And I want a vibrant alumni association, and that's something which I keep on saying, and I will actually keep on. The fact is, it is important, because I was trying to read a book, but I read, your network is your net worth. You agree? Your network is your net worth. In a world of finance, networking is also important. You have knowledge, but you don't have a network, not going to do so well. But your only network and no knowledge also will not do well. That's okay. Because in the shorter run, you will succeed, but in the middle or the long run, you vanish. But the fact is, you have a strong network, definitely succeed. Coming to the green bonds, I'm going to tell you that greenwashing is a disaster. You start with something, you know, something like, I would say, analogy like an electric car. Electric cars have started, and some electric cars or electric scooters started burning. I don't believe in that product. You think that, you know, electric cars are not good, electric scooters are not good, you know, fair. But the fact is that electric cars are good. Good for the system, good for the climate. Just because some technology, some batteries have exploded, how many of you know some batteries of even Apple phone or even other phones have exploded, right? But there are different reasons for that. A few accidents on the road doesn't mean that you don't drive on the road anymore. You just put things in order. And hence I am saying the same thing for green bonds. The world over has understood that they have to put things in order. But the polluting industries, the polluting companies have to decide what are the right ESG benchmarks in the world. And I like that comparison, Professor Sehgal, that you said China has a down-up approach, which is better. If you fix the accountability on the industry, the economy will be safer. I remember one day, when I was young, and somebody actually gave me the right advice, and I understood it. And I said, I'm young and I want to change the world. Right? Everybody thinks that. I don't want to change the world. I want to impact the world. I want to impact the society. I'm sure you say impact the society, the world. Everybody says that. First, impact your neighborhood. The society will get impacted, and your nation will get impacted, the world will get impacted. Change the neighborhood. If you take the decision of not throwing one paper in that dustbin, or not in the dustbin, I'm sure the world will change. Start there. But don't summarize, don't do things that let's do to change the world. The fact that's more for the politicians, not for us. We as managers, we make an impact in our areas of influence. We make an impact at our own companies that we work for, and that's something is our importance. Careers, as I'm coming back, don't get, you know, stressed out on your days of, you know, when companies come and recruit or don't recruit you. Why I say don't recruit you? Because you know your own worth. The companies may not be able to understand that HR person or whoever comes from the company cannot decide who you are in the 10 or 15 minutes or a document that is tested. Right? But you know who you are. So if you decide to become an entrepreneur, so be it. If you don't get a better job, so be it. You get a job. Prove yourself. Jump the ladder. It is the first few years that you decide for yourself as to where you want to reach. And hence, don't get disheartened that he got a fancy job. You know that fancy jobs? We got some fancy, I'm not going to name the company so it doesn't look good. But fancy jobs with non-fancy work, whereas a non-fancy job with a fancy work, as I'll choose the second one, right? But that's where the learning will come, the knowledge curve will come. And that's the first few years or 5 years, I would say, pick up a job which actually learn. So guys, you have the enablers in place. You have new things to understand. When you're talking of greenhouse emissions, hydrogen is a new future. The new way to live life is a new future.
Your world is going to change, let me tell you. We have lived in a world of little more stability. When climate change, we funds to the best of the companies, but then there are companies which are not the best of the companies, they also require funds. And that challenge of risk assessment, I use the word risk assessment, and I think that's the fundamental thing that I've learned at MFC. Return and risk go hand in hand. If you find anything that is higher risky, you get a higher return, but you understand that if you are able to assess the risks properly, mitigate those risks properly, you get good returns, and same applies to your lives. If you are able to assess the risks that are ahead of you, and you are able to take and mitigate them, you have a great life. Wishing you everyone the best of a career. Yeah. Thank you.
He is also currently working as the Managing Director at Bank of Baroda Capital Markets Limited. Next up, we have...
Ikta, will you please bring the vacuum planter for our Chief of Gifts for the day, Mr. Florent Diesting. Professor Florent Diesting is the Director of Social Transition at TBS Education. Holding a PhD in economics, he holds numerous publications on financial markets and financial derivatives. Currently, he focuses on incorporating the sustainable development goals into business school curriculum to meet future challenges and solutions. We are honored to have him as a guest of honor for today's convention. If the will you please bring the planter for our guest of
world of journalism. With 32 years of dedicated service in the media, she has been a prominent news anchor for 22 years. Currently serving as the managing editor at NDTV, she has left an indelible mark on the industry. Her illustrious career has spanned iconic news organizations such as NewsTrack, Zee, BBC and DITV. She has not only reported but have also grown and adapted to the ever-changing landscape of news reporting. One of her most notable achievements is hosting NDTV Desh Ki Baat at 6 PM, a show that connects with audiences across the nation from urban to rural areas. Additionally, they led the general news broadcast at 8 PM. Recognized for her outstanding contributions, Ms. Kulpati received the Pandit Hari Dutt Sharma Award in 2017, the News Broadcasting Award and the National Television Award in 2010. She was
I would like to call Mr. Muni, Professor Munish Kumar, to felicitate Nidhi ma'am.
For this invite, and thank you so much for this award. It means a lot, very humbling, and I want to congratulate the Department of Finance and Business Economics. So when I was told the day before yesterday, and by the way, I want to really thank all the professors here. After long, it was nice to hear all of you. You know, it's always so good to learn, and it's a blessing to be here. And certain words I've picked up, and I'll just mention them, that how very important it is for us to always get information, get news, and evolve with time. When I was told that I have to be here, I was really perplexed because I'm a student of social issues, of politics, and I really don't understand finance and business. It just goes beyond our head, but we have to manage our everyday lives. But in the morning today, it really struck me that how we all are living in a world that is always changing. We are evolving. And that is how it's really come across. Because my generation has come from stability. We've seen a lot of stability of life, of situation, of our work, of our education. But now things are changing, evolving. अब जब हम लोग काम करते थे करते हैं अभी तो हमारे लिए एक हमारी जो नौकरी में तनख्वाह आती है वही एक आय का जरिया है, वही जीवन यापन का हमारा जरिया है।
इन्वेस्ट कर लिए, LEDs पुराने जमाने की हो गई हैं। और उसी तरह जो हमारी न्यूज है, फाइनेंस की वर्ल्ड बदली है लेकिन हमारी न्यूज की वर्ल्ड कितनी बदल गई। जब हम लोग थे अखबार पढ़ते थे, टेलीविजन आया तो कहा गया न्यूज़पेपर समाप्त हो जाएगा, बट न्यूज़पेपर बना टेलीविजन के। मैं पहले भी कहती थी आज से 30 साल पहले कि रीढ़ की हड्डी है न्यूज़पेपर्स, आज भी हम सब के लिए रीढ़ की हड्डी है। न्यूज़पेपर्स के बाद अब टेलीविजन तो शायद बहुत कम लोग देखते हैं। आप लोग टेलीविजन देखते हैं? हाँ बताइए जरा, हाथ उठाइए अगर आप इंफॉर्मेशन लेते हैं। एज ऑल द प्रोफेसर्स एंड सर्स एंड वी आर सेड एंड आई मेट रशिद एंड विश्वम, सो दे सेड कि हम न्यूज़पेपर्स तो पढ़ते हैं, फाइनेंशियल टाइम्स एंड ऑल दोस। आप लोग अखबार पढ़ते हैं? So actually one person said here, hausla zai ke liye shukriya. Lekin but aap ye bataiye ki phone pe aap log news dekhte hain ki nahi dekhte hain?
Yes.
Ha. So seems so aan ek samay aa jayega bahut jaldi kuch saalon mein artificial intelligence, you know, you will just say we'll send a screenshot.
Hamari news ka bhi yahi dhyay hai, purpose is very important. प्रॉफिट में खो नहीं जाना चाहिए। और पर्पज की वर्ड्स फॉर यू ऑल टूडे, इट इज वेरी इंफॉर्मेशन इम्पॉर्टेंट कि आप स्टैंड, यू नो दिस इज व्हाट वी आर ब्रीथिंग अराउंड, दैट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, व्हाट वी आर ईटिंग अराउंड इज इम्पॉर्टेंट। एज प्रोफेसर सराफिया सेड दैट जंक फूड मत खाइए, मदर्स मट बी सेइंग दैट बट मदर्स आर ऑल अर्थ इज योर नेटवर्क, बट आई एम टेलिंग यू इन दिस लाइफ व्हाट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट इज take information from them, be around them, be empathetic. But I'm not saying that empathy runs the world of you all, because you're changing in such times which is totally unstable. Hawa saaf saaf hum aapko nahi de pa rahe hain, jalvayu kam ho jati hai. We're living less 12 years as compared to one of the greenest capitals. I'm thankful to whatever work it's being done here. But reach across, educate people, and jis tarah se demand hogi, waise hi उस पर काम किया जाए, सिर्फ लाइटली, बिकॉज ये हम बड़े लोग कह देते हैं आप लोगों को जो उम्र दराज लोग हैं कि आप फ्यूचर हैं, आप संभाल लीजिए देश को, लेकिन नहीं, आप लोग यू आर द ड्राइविंग फोर्स, यू हैव टू टेक अप अ स्टैंड, अंडरस्टैंड, मेक योर एयर बेटर, मेक योर फूड बेटर, मेक योर लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड्स बेटर एंड द कम्युनिटी अराउंड यू, पीपल अराउंड यू, योर फैमिली, दैट शुड मैटर, योर फ्रेंड्स, सो मच।
With us. Advancing further, we are about to commence our award ceremony.
Good morning. Thank you for the invitation. I prefer presentation, but it's not working. But I will do without. It's not a problem. It's an honor for me to be there. The last time it was in 2019. Yeah, 4 years ago. It's a long time, but for me it's like yesterday. But during the last 4 years, the world changed a lot. And I would like to talk about the role of higher education and mainly of the business school to help the world to change, to help the company to change. Because a recent study showed that 99% of solutions about climate change, diversity, inclusion, CSR in general, are inside the company. It means the responsibility of higher education, university, business school, engineering school is to prepare the future generation, the future responsible manager, engineer to be ready against this kind of challenge. In France, we have a different framework, national and international recognition like accreditation, and each of them try to develop their needs and ask about sustainability, about CSR. For example, with international American accreditation, it's called AACSB, they ask us to present, develop, and prove our societal impact. It means we have to define which kind of impact, positive impact, we want to have, and we would like to have, and after to measure that. Another international accreditation is called EQUIS, asked the business school to demonstrate its CSR policy in all parts of the school. In our strategy, global strategy, but also for the campus facilities, HR management, financial management, curriculum, faculty management, everywhere. But in also we have a different kind of...
Present two very short example and case study that we have in France. 3 years ago, there is a report from a group of students. We asked two committees on climate change, but also on health limit, on diversity, university in France. But to prepare that, we have also to train our faculty, to prepare our faculty to introduce more about sustainability and 20 business schools in France. It's called the CDEFM. It's a conference for the head of financial management, French management school, and 6 for the master level. Started to describe the environment and the earth limit, for example, to implement a new solution. And it will be again a requirement. It means all the university and business school, we have to apply this English, of course. And it's again a tool to try to implement new knowledge for mission to accompany the business and the companies.
Award, the Academic Excellence Award. This award is being given to the best performing student. It goes to Mr. Anuj Mittal in recognition of the best performance in the batch of 2021-23. Mr. Mittal is currently thriving as a senior consultant at EY GDS, and we extend our heartfelt congratulations and best wishes for his future endeavors. As an alumnus of our department, and we look forward to celebrating his achievements and contributions. I would request our chief guest to felicitate Mr. Mukesh.
My thoughts with everyone. So, you know, this award means a lot to me. Almost 2 decades back, almost 20 years back, I was sitting in the audience. And, you know, I could have never imagined that I'll be getting this award. It's, you know, really difficult at times to visualize that future will be so good. And what I feel is that, you know, whatever I'm today is because of the department, because of the Delhi University. I did my master's in finance here. I also did my doctorate. And, you know, Professor Munish Kumar, Professor Sehgal, they're like father figures. You know, they've always guided me and, you know, always helped me. So really thanks to both of them, to the whole of the department, and you know, to everyone for this recognition. Thank you so much. Means a lot.
To come forward and felicitate our esteemed chief guest, Mr. Sanjeev Saraf.
As our guest of honor. Thank
you. We will now take a 15-minute tea break, after which our post-technical session on consulting will commence. Please return to your seats by 11. Thank you.